20 years ago this month, my mother died unexpectedly, but very peacefully in Houston. And when I think about that, I remember so well that her favorite season of the whole year was Easter. And I remember as a child, she would read the Easter story to us with such conviction that I never doubted its authenticity. And my sister and I, my mother, would go to church, but before that we would have our Easter egg hunts at the house, and then we would go to church, then another Easter egg hunt at the church, then we would come back and have Easter presents, and we seemed to always get little chickens and little rabbits, and sometimes even little ducks. And so Easter was such a joyous time for us. And when she died, my sister and I picked out my mother's favorite hymn, which is Jesus Christ is Risen Today. And we sang that as the processional hymn. It was during Lent, but that was okay. And because of that hymn, and because it reminds us that Easter is the Queen of Feasts, and our faith hangs on really the Easter faith and that resurrection of Jesus, I am reminded of some of the things that Easter really causes me to think about. I think, first of all, as Jesus lived and still lives, we are called to care for others. We are given that gift to care for others who are maybe the downtrodden and who are they just have so little. And we're called to look after them and care for them. And we are reminded of that so poignantly by the Good Samaritan story, because if we ever wonder who our neighbor is, we just have to remember Jesus telling the Good Samaritan story. Secondly, as Jesus lived and as he lives today, we are given a conscience, a strong, powerful conscience, to look at people and see them differently. And I'm reminded of Jesus giving place, an equal place, to those who were pushed aside and that were marginalized. He gave equal voice to children, to women, to those who were ill, to prisoners. And we are called to do no less. And I think thirdly, as Jesus lived and as he lives, we were given that sense of forgiveness that he imparted to so many. And I'm never forgetful, or I'm always reminded of that wonderful story that we call the prodigal son, but really it's about two brothers and a loving father, because, you know, both of those brothers needed punishment. They deserved punishment, but their father gave them forgiveness and acceptance and love, and we are called to do no less. So this Easter day and this Easter season, I'm not only reminded of my mother and her gift to me and her witness, but I'm reminded of the great fact of the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has given me at least these three things to think about and to participate in, and to live my life as he lived his, but to follow and pattern my life after his. May you and your family and those closest to you have a blessed, blessed Easter and a blessed and joyful Easter season.